Hello everyone, I am Ritvik and have made already a lecture on mechanics, a very good problem. And this is my lecture too. And it's a very nice problem from S.S. Croteau book, and I recommend you to do that too. And also, don't forget to subscribe to the channel, and previously I have not told it. So please apologize me, and I am giving acknowledgements to Ethan sir and INSP YouTube channel. And हाँ यार, मैंने कमेंट्स पढ़ा था. आई हैव रेड द कमेंट्स द लास्ट वीडियो, एंड थैंक यू फॉर द सपोर्ट इन द कमेंट्स यार. रियली यार, आई विल रीड द कमेंट्स, एंड इफ यू हैव एनी डाउट्स इन द वीडियो, यू कैन पोस्ट इट इन द कमेंट्स, एंड आई विल ट्राई टू रीच एज मेनी एज पीपल हैव आई कैन. एंड यार, लेट्स गो टू द प्रॉब्लम. यार, वी हैव वन प्रॉब्लम. इट इज बेसिकली फ्रॉम वर्क फॉर एनर्जी. And we can do this problem in two methods. One from using work for energy, and we can apply torque and force F equal to ma type applications. First, we will solve the problem. And the book has officially given the solution from the work for energy method. First, we will do in the method one, that is, which is work for energy, and method two is in the which is a normal solution, and it is a I think many of you can solve it in the normal solution from torque and F equal to ma applications. Let me show the problem here. This is a problem. Let me read it. A ring of mass M. This is the ring. I will call it in the problem. It has bead. Don't re it, because these both are rings, and I will call this small ring as a bead, not to confuse you people. And they given that its mass is m, connecting freely to identical thin hoops. It is connected at the intersection point of these two thin rings of mass capital M. These both masses are equal to capital M each. Start sliding down. Why it will slide down, I will show you a small animation video. You can understand it. Please wait for a few seconds. The hoops move apart over a rough horizontal surface. They have given that it's a rough horizontal surface, and determine the acceleration A of the ring at the initial instant. Okay, they are asking us the acceleration of the small bead at the first instant after the after it of the after the motion starts, and they're given this angle as alpha. Okay, this is a figure, and neglecting the friction between the ring and hoops. They have given that we need to neglect the friction between the small bead and the large rings. Okay, let me show you the animation. What I have made, we generally call in our classes as cheap animation techniques, and I have made by using them. Let's see it there. It's a very good animation. Yeah, please see it. I am showing you how does it work actually, how the bead falls. And here they have given that it's this intersection point. They have shown it as a bead, and these two are the large rings in our case. And this is a horizontal surface, the white line down, which is bold. It is a horizontal surface, and these two rings will move farther away from each other, and this intersection point will fall down. Okay, just observe it here. Okay. Let me highlight the points. Now see it here. This point, which is moving down, see it. When the hoops, when the larger rings are moving away from each other, this intersection point start falling down. And they have asked the acceleration of this point at the very first instant when it starts falling down. I hope that you have understood the question, at least from the animation. And thank you. Now I will show you the. Now I request you people to read the question again and try it at least for 10 to 15 minutes, as it is a very good problem. Give it a try. Okay. I hope you have tried the problem, and please pause the video and try again. Okay. Yeah. Let me go into solution. Yeah. First, we are doing the work for energy method. Okay. I'm going to discuss both the methods in this video. Okay, just to follow the pointer, don't read everything before only, as you can't understand it. Okay. Here we have I have drawn the both rings and the bead, and I have shown it as mass M and mass capital M as for both weights. I'm giving the velocity of rings as Vr and velocity of bead as Vb, and the angle given is alpha. By symmetry, both the this angle is alpha. By symmetry, we can say that even this angle will be alpha because the masses of both bigger rings are equal. And after I have shown the animation as if they move apart, the smaller the bead falls down, and let me show you it. The bead will fall down. If the bead falls down, I have given it as Vb and alpha. Okay, I think that it's clear. And we are assuming the radius capital R for the rings. Okay, let's read the sentences. As shown in the animation, if the big rings are slipping, the bead falls down. Here, I have explained you. I have given the velocities as Vr and Vb. And because they have mentioned that it's having a rough surface efficient for pure rolling, so we'll apply the pure rolling conditions here. Omega equal to velocity of ring by radius of the ring. And here we got the equation, and I'm giving it as equation number one. From another constraint relation, we have learned in the Newton laws of motion that velocity along the string is a constant. Same in the same way, as the velocity of the ring is in the horizontal direction, velocity along this normal line, velocity along this line will be constant for the bead and as well as our both rings. Because the ring is moving in the VR direction and this angle is alpha, let me draw it here. This angle also will be alpha, and this thing will be VR cos alpha. VR cos alpha equal to velocity of bead into this is alpha, this is again 90 minus alpha. Otherwise, you can see it from here. This is Vr cos alpha, this is Vb, and this is 90 minus alpha, this is Vb 90 minus alpha. In the same way here, Vb 90 minus alpha. Vb 90 minus alpha will be the component here, and Vr cos alpha will be the component here. So velocity along this line must be equal. So I have given this equation. Let me erase everything here. I have given here Vb sin alpha equal to Vr cos alpha. We have got this relation from the Newton law of motion constraint. Okay, now let's move. For dt time, as I have asked again, let me show the question. They have asked instantaneous acceleration here. Determine the acceleration of the ring at the initial instant. They have asked instantaneous acceleration. So I'm assuming that that instantaneous acceleration, whatever it will be, it is for dx length when it is falling for dt time. Let the bead fall dx in dt time. So for that instant, we can assume the acceleration to be constant because it's very, very small instant. For small instant, we can assume that accelerations are constant and we can apply it here. And I've taken that Vb square. We have already studied in our early classes. It is a V final minus V square minus U square equal to 2s. I have applied the same kinematics logic here. Vb square minus 0 initial velocity equal to 2a. We have assumed the constant acceleration here and dx. And we got this equation here. And next, let me go into the next slide here. And we can also apply that loss in potential energy will be gain in kinetic energy. So let me write the kinetic energy of two rings first. Half into m into Vr square. Vr square is a translation kinetic energy. Half into m into Vr square of one ring. And half into I omega square is a rotational kinetic energy. And as they are rings, we can substitute mr square as I here. And I am multiplying it by 2 because there are two rings here. And the kinetic energy of ring we will get after substituting I equal to mr square and vr equal to omega equal to vr by r because it is a pure rolling condition. I have explained you already. After substituting both the values, we will get kinetic energy of both the rings equal to m into vr square, 2 into m into vr square. And we can say that For dx length slipping, we can tell that loss in potential will be mgh and h equal to dx. We can tell that mg into dx will be the loss in potential. And the kinetic energy gain will be kinetic energy of rings plus kinetic energy of bead. Kinetic of energy of bead is half into m into vb square, where vb is the velocity of the bead. And kinetic energy of the ring, just we have derived and we substitute here in the value. And loss in potential energy is mg dx. And the kinetic energy of bead equal to half into m into vb square and kinetic energy of rings. And this substituting from here. We are, I think there are no doubts up to this equation. Let's move on to the next page. From equation 2, let's see equation 2. The equation 2 was this here, the constant which we have applied from the Newton laws chapter. From equation 2, we can tell that Vb tan alpha equal to Vr, where Vb is velocity of bead and Vr is the velocity of rings. And from equation 3, we can depict that acceleration, the value of dx equal to Vb square upon 2a. I have written here the same thing here. Vb tan alpha equal to Vr and dx equal to Vb square upon 2a. Just we will substitute these both equations in the equation we have got recently. This one, mg dx equal to the energy conservation equation. Yeah, just I will substitute this, no worries. Okay. Mg into dx we got as Vb square upon 2a. I have substituted here and half into m into Vb square was the kinetic energy of the bead. And 2m into Vr equal to Vb Vr square. We got it as the kinetic energy of beads. I hope you remember, and I will show you again. Kinetic energy of beads, kinetic energy of rings, we got as 2 into m into Vr square. And just I am keeping 2 into m into Vr square. I am substituting the value of Vr square from the constant relation of Newton laws. I have applied here. 2m into Vr as Vb tan alpha from here, as it is whole square, Vb square tan square alpha. From all the sides, Vb square cancels, and by rearranging, we will get the value of acceleration of as g by 1 plus 4 m by m tan square alpha. It's the correct answer here, whoever got it, congratulations, and I will explain you in the next method also. Once I think it how the approach is, and because it's a totally different approach which is given in the book, so you need time to understand. Okay, I will show you the second method also, method 2. I'm just drawing the FBD of ring and the bead. I have drawn only one ring here. Assume that there is also another ring. Because of one ring, you will have a normal reaction along this line N. And because of symmetry and due to another ring also, you will have normal reaction N only. You draw the another thing and it is M. If I draw the FBD of the bead, 2N mg minus 2N sine alpha. This angle is alpha. We can just see it from here. N cos alpha will be cancelled and N sine alpha will be the component here. Mg minus 2n sine alpha, as it is moving down and taking acceleration as a, mg minus 2n sine alpha equal to ma. I have taken it as equation number 1. Next, I am drawing the FBDs on the ring here. Because there is an n cos alpha which is cancelling out on the bead due to the ring, same n cos alpha will be applied in the backward direction because of Newton's third law on the ring by the bead. I'm repeating it again. Because there is an n cos alpha on the bead by this ring, there will be the same n cos alpha on the ring by the bead, but in the different direction because of Newton's third law. And here it will be n cos alpha by the torque. By the torque, we can say that the friction direction will be here because I am taking alpha as in the anti-clockwise sense. To satisfy it, and taking friction as here. If you will take friction towards negative x-axis also, you will just get the negative answer. That's it. And again, we will prove that friction equal to here. Okay. And n cos alpha minus f. I'm just writing another. And I'm assuming the ring is moving with an acceleration a1. Okay. and n cos alpha minus m equal to capital M mass of ring into A1, and V. And after that, I am writing the torque equation about center of mass of the ring. We can write torque equation from here also. Why I am writing about the center of mass means, if we will write the torque equation from the point which is in the contact, we need to consider a new force, which is pseudo force acting on the ring. So not to make the problem complex, I am writing the torque equation from the center of mass of this ring. And the torque equation is all the forces on this ring and normal reaction on the ground, its mass, and the reaction force n sin alpha. Everything will be cancelled because everything is passing through the center, and this F into R, only this will be remaining in the outward direction, and it is equal to I alpha, and alpha is also outward direction, as I have explained previously. FR equal to I alpha, I'm just keeping I equal to MR square, and FR equal to I alpha, I will get that F equal to M into A1. And this I am substituting in this equation, which we have got previously from F equal to MA equation. I will get N cos alpha equal to 2 into MA1. This is the equation number 2. Okay. Once again read the slide, you will understand everything clearly. Let me move to the next slide. From constant again, we can say that, A, this is acceleration A downward to the bead. A, this is 90 minus alpha. Let me show you. This is 90 minus alpha. A cos 90 minus alpha, which is A sin alpha, equal to A1. I'm taking the acceleration as A1. And along this line, this is alpha, and this is also will be alpha, A1 cos alpha. Means here, A sin alpha equal to A1 cos alpha. Okay. I hope that you understood from the constraint. And let me show you. The same we got. A sin alpha equal to A1 cos alpha. Let me erase it here. Okay. And I am taking it as the equation number 3. I am substituting this equation in the previous equation, equation number 2, which we have got N cos alpha equal to 2N into A1. And after substituting, we'll get value of n as 2m into a sine theta upon cos square alpha. And I'm giving a new equation variable, new equation number 4. And I'm substituting this fourth equation in the very first equation which we have got it. Let me show the equation. This equation, mg minus 2n sine alpha equal to m. I'm substituting normal reaction value here. mg minus 2n sine alpha. After substituting, we will get mg minus 2 into n sin alpha will become n is a 2m into a sin alpha upon cos square alpha. Another sin alpha will come from the equation as I have written here. Because of that, another sin alpha, sin square upon cos square, will become tan square alpha and equal to ma. Okay. Just by rearranging the values, we will get a equal to g upon 1 plus 4m upon tan square alpha, which we have proved in the first method also. Let me show you. G upon 1 plus 4m upon m tan square alpha. This is the answer here for this question. I hope you have liked the video. Please like, share, and subscribe the video. And thanks for sir and all the students who are commenting in a very positive manner and liked it. Thank you everyone for giving me such great opportunity. Thank you. Bye.
Next, one of my batch is coming very soon. It is RM 2.2, and I have very good memories of last year's RM batch. So because of that, and it was a very good success in my opinion, that's the reason we are launching the same batch with the same team. So this batch starts on 26th of January, and we'll be starting from the electrostatics. All right. So last year in this batch, I covered both 11th and 12th. So it started in March, and by November, December, you can say entire 11th and 12th in full detail we have covered. So those who are interested, they can definitely look for this batch.